Mwaka wa 1984 uliingia kwenye kumbukumbu kufuatia mauaji ya Wagala. Maelfu ya vijana wenye asili ya Kisomali waliuawa kwa ukatili pale kaunti ya Wajir. Tukio hili likiuka haki za kibinadamu kwenye historia ya Kenya. Lakini mwaka huo huo, upande wa pwani, Bwana na Bimbugwa walibarikiwa kupata mapacha, na mmoja wao alikuwa Janet Mbugwa Ndichu.
I'm also a twin, so tulizaliwa Mombasa. Yes, I have a twin brother.
Lakini tulibishana sana. Hizi ma scratches hapa si ati maisha ni Janet tu.
I have this very deep voice. So nilikuwa conscious kidogo, but when I got to the age of 14 nilianza debate. Na nilichaguliwa kwa debate club and I won best speaker in Mombasa. At that time nilikuwa 17. Alisema you need to enter media. You need to use, because pia nilikuwa nafanya debates na verse speaking na hizo vitu zote huko Brookhouse. Nilikuwa house captain. I was really into leadership. Joroge Mwaura now came to me. He was like the godfather of news. I was like, yeah, I didn't even know how to talk to him. I'm like, yes, sir. He said, I think you have something. When the contract for Out and About Elisha in August 2007, nilirudi tena Mombasa to my mom and dad. Nikasema, ay, wanasema niingie news, but I'm not sure. So my mom and dad are very supportive. They said, okay, you do what you want to, but remember, it's a very good opportunity and it's a job, more importantly. After 1 week, wakasema, you're ready for 1 o'clock news. Remember, I've only trained for 2 days. And I was trained by Joroge Mwaura and a lady called Jennifer, I forget her second name. 2 days, 1 week late night news, alafu wakasema, you're now ready for 1 o'clock news. This was still 2007. Nilifanya 1 o'clock news, wakasema, you're ready for weekend prime. Hivo tu.
Mwaka wa 2007, ulikuwa mwaka wa kupiga kura nchini Kenya. Janet, naye alitakikana kuchukua majukumu zaidi pale kazini.
Then 2009, two things happened. One, there was a South African media house walikuwa wanatafuta watangazaji from around the continent. And me and Esther Runga at the time, we were good friends, we were approached. They said, Esther and Janet wanakutafuta. And I was like, ah, saitu nimeuliza kufanya main prime time, wacha tu, wacha ikai kidogo. Esther and I were promoted with Lillian Muli to prime time news. I could be wrong, but I think Lillian, me and Esther were like the group that kind of started making news
I
young.
I really love that Janet played a role in switching that up and changing it up and making news different and interesting. You know, the formats changed. And not only that, you could see some little lightheartedness and, you know, and banter and jokes whilst you're watching the news. It wasn't just formal and serious.
TV, kuna vile inafaa, especially news. Unajua news ni kitu very serious. From a long time ago, nilikuwa najiambia, it's not about you. It's about the content.
Janet amekuwa na ujasiri wa kujaribu mambo mapya na mwaka 2013 aliamua kuigiza.
I'm that kind of person who kama kuna kitu sijajaribu, wacha tu nijaribu. Nione kama nitafail ama kama nitafaulu. I was offered this role, nikasema okay, I enjoyed it. My character alikuwa anaitwa Pendo. Pendo alikuwa magazine editor, so ilikuwa kama similar kwa media, trying to fight wars kama sexism na nini. I would take my own experiences and put it in my character. 2015 was my wedding, but 2015 was also the year I was expecting my son. Niliolewa May 30th, 2015, and we welcomed our son on October 26th, 2015. So 2015 is one of the biggest years of my life. Two things, papa, I don't waste time. I thought they were joking. I was like, ah, see Larry. They were like, what do you mean, why Larry? As in, we need to interview you and take your photo. I said, ah, see Larry. I will need to me an email. Don't you know it's real? So they sent me an email. So we literally called Norfolk, because Norfolk was the day they were awarding us. That day I really was humbled. Now even the other women I'm about to call now, I don't know, it was a very humbling experience because there are so many incredible women in Kenya. There's so many incredible women doing so many things. So to be picked among the 40 till today, is the most humbling I've ever, I think, felt.